Raven and Other Poems and Tales was published! Oh, I love it!
Good morning.
Oh, hi, Egg!
I have an 11 o'clock appointment with Mr. Merriman.
Oh, Mr. Merriman!
Eddie! Great to see you, babe. Come in, come in! Hey, Desiree, hold my calls, babe.
Yeah, that'll be easy since the telephone hasn't been invented yet. Hey, I swear.
So, you look like you got a little sun there, Eddie. You better be careful or you'll lose that pasty pallor of yours. Sit down, take a load off, relax.
So you wanted to see me?
Yeah, I did. And all this stuff you sent me, now, I love these stories you wrote. You know, the fall of the House of Usher, the telltale heart, the murders in the Rue Morgue.
Oh, and they're all so much fun to write.
Yeah. But this latest thing.
The Raven?
The Raven. You see, I'm thinking we need to take your career in a whole new direction.
New direction?
You know, you've done this whole dark and creepy thing. I mean, once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary. Come on, Bubby! That's depressing.
But life is depressing.
Well, yeah, maybe for you, Eduardo, but people don't want to read about it. I mean, listen, your guy here in the Raven poem. I mean, couldn't he ponder smiley and jovial on a Sunday afternoon?
No, he couldn't. He's in pain over his lost love, Lenore. You're not smiley and jovial when you lose someone you love.
Yeah, but we don't know that yet. I mean, couldn't he be happy at first, then, you know, get a little blue, and then maybe by the end, boom, he's happy again.
My poem is about the heartbroken man, tormented by the memory of his lost love. I'm not going to change it.
No. Shh. Of course not, Eddie. Baby, you shouldn't change it because it is brilliant.
Thank you.
But I just don't know.
What?
Well, you know, this Raven. I mean, thanks for sending it along with the manuscript. Nice gimmick, yeah. But the poem's not really working.
What about the Raven?
In the poem, could he be a bunny?
A bunny? Absolutely not.
But Edgar, a raven's such a big, ugly bird.
Nevermore!
Nobody likes ravens. But a bunny. Come on, they're so cute. Who could resist?
Let me get this straight. You would like me to change my poem to say, quoth the bunny nevermore? No, a fluffy, cute little bunny wouldn't, but an ugly black raven with ugly feet and a beak that speaks evil would.
Nevermore! Okay, he's a raven. I'll give you that one. But really, this nevermore stuff, I'm telling you, Eddie, you are blowing your chances for any kind of sequel.
Look, I don't need you. I can sell this on my own.
Nevermore!
Do yourself a favor and listen to that pigeon, Edgar. You'll never make it in this town without me, buddy. You'll be back.
And the raven is still considered to be a remarkable example of flawless literary construction. It really is.
My latest book is a monstrous tale I call Frankenstein.
Oh, and they're all so much fun to write.
Thank you! Thank you!